Matrices of the same order, row by column, one more time, are added or subtracted by adding or subtracting the corresponding element. So basically, if you can add two numbers and you're good with your working with signs, positive negatives, then you can add matrices. You just find the corresponding elements and add them. So we have first row and first column, and first row and first column. So, you know, 2 plus negative 4 is going to be equal to negative 2. Oh, well, wait a minute. I just added those corresponding elements, but that ain't right. This is, let's see here. I guess we'll use red for it being wrong. This is a 2-row, 3-column matrix. And this one is going to be a 3-row. And let's try that again. 3-row and 2-column matrix. You can't add those. The thing I just said, they have to be of the same order. Now, I was able to do, you know, the first row and first column, this 2, with this first row and this first column, the negative 4, and get negative 2. But as I continue through here and I get to the negative 6, that is the first row and third column. Well, first row and there is no third column, and you can't flip-flop the row and columns. That's just not allowed. Okay, now you cannot add these two matrices. But what you're going to find out later in this lesson is you could actually multiply those, but we haven't gotten there yet. So those do not add. This has no answer. Bada bing, bada boom. Moving on. Now over here, now I'm going to work all of this out because this might be the first time you've ever seen addition or subtraction with matrices. We do have 2 rows and 3 columns and 2 rows and 3 columns. So now we are going to add or subtract two matrices of the same order. And again, you just match up those corresponding elements and add or, in this case, subtract them. So we're going to have, let's see here, negative 3 minus 0. And I'm just writing all this out for practice. 2 minus 3 and 1 minus, okay, now we have a minus. We are subtracting these matrices, and that particular element in the first row and third column, that negative 9, that's going to introduce or has a, no, hold on a second. I wasn't sure if I was hearing static. There are some papers moving around, so move things around, adjusted the mic. Let's try it again. So we have negative 3 and 0. We have 2 and minus 3. Now again, we are subtracting these matrices and we're subtracting a negative number. Don't forget to include or deal with that extra negative. So we're going to have 1 minus negative 9. It's a little bit harder to miss those two negatives when you're actually writing out all of the subtraction, but you're probably pretty comfortable with addition and subtraction, and you're not going to want to do this every time you add or subtract matrices. 5 minus negative 4. Negative 7 minus 1, and 0 minus 1. And that means our final answer, doing all this arithmetic, we have negative 3 minus 0 is negative 3, and now we have negative 1. 1 minus a negative 9, of course, these two negatives canceling out, giving us addition. 1 plus 9 is going to be equal to 10. Again, here with these two negatives. Oh, and by the way, these negatives are canceling because you are effectively doing... chalk down! We're doing negative 1 times negative 9. Now, negative 1 times negative 9 is positive 9. And so you have your 1 plus 9 is equal to 10. 5 plus 4 is equal to 9. And negative 7 and negative 1, of course, subtraction is a movement to the left on the number line. So if you're at 0 and you go left 7 and left one more unit, you're at negative 8, and then finally 0 minus 1 is negative 1, and that is our sum. That is our new matrix that we got from taking these two matrices and subtracting them. I guess I could have some notation up here. You could call this matrix A and this matrix B. So of course now this is going to be matrix A minus matrix B. Over here we have a couple of 2x2 matrices, 2 rows and 2 columns, 2 rows and 2 columns. Again, adding up those corresponding elements, 2 plus negative 2 is going to be 0. And we have negative 1 plus positive 1 is 0 again. It's a little bit weird. We have 4 plus 4. which is equal to 8, but I did actually want this to be an identity matrix, so that means I miscopied one of these signs. Let's just introduce a negative here. 4 plus negative 4 is equal to 0. See, if things don't work out, I can just change the problems to suit my needs. Just don't do that on the test. Your teacher won't like it very much. 5 plus negative 5 is going to be equal to 0. And, you know, something, let's see here. I just added these two matrices and got a zero matrix. Well, don't, you know, remember your properties of addition. If you add by zero, nothing happens. So zero is the additive identity. Well, you know, if I took this matrix of 2, negative 1, 4, 5 and added it with the matrix of zero, it would get the same answer of 2, negative 1, 4, 5. Adding by, I'm still really just adding just a bunch of little individual elements. So this is the additive identity matrix. Just a zero matrix, and that means that these are additive inverses. You might also think of them as opposites. So that is how you add matrices. Just make sure that they're the same size and just add or subtract the corresponding elements. Properties of matrix addition. You know, those examples we just got done working out. If matrix A, B, and C, well, if they are M by N matrices, and 0 is the M by N 0 matrix. So even though we're talking about a 0 matrix adding by 0 and nothing sort of occurring, if you will, that 0 matrix still needs to be the same size, the same order as, you know, whatever three matrices we're, you know, going to point out in these properties. Then we have A plus B, matrix A plus matrix B is equal to matrix B plus matrix A. And, you know, just like, you know, regular addition is commutative, we have that commutative property with matrices as well. We also have the associative property. If we have some grouping where A plus B are going to get added first and then you add C, well, you can regroup that and have A plus the grouping, the parentheses, B plus C. So instead of adding A and B first, you can add B and C first, then add A, and you'll get the same answer. I discussed this quickly in the previous scene. We have A plus 0, matrix A plus the 0 matrix of the same order, is still going to give you an answer of A. That's the additive identity property. And if you add two matrices together and you get that 0 matrix, then those are additive inverses. Now,